it is completely unimaginable, and we're not at the peak yet. Apart from two patients, every patient we're looking after has got COVID. We can't cope with a big spike. We just can't. This is one of the doctors here.
75. All the patients here are critically ill.
We're planning for many more patients, so all our theatres to be full of COVID patients and possibly beyond. It is, you know, none of us have ever seen anything like this.
This used to be a recovery area for patients after surgery. Now it's an intensive care unit for COVID-19 patients. A huge part of the hospital has been transformed in order to deal with coronavirus.
I've been in intensive care nursing for about 23 years now, and I've never seen anything like this. Even the London bombings, I've never seen it in such a short, condensed period of time.
Many of the patients here are elderly or have underlying health problems, but not all.
I think perhaps I was a bit naive when we started. I'd assumed that it would be the older and the sicker. In here, we've got a mixture from people in their 40s to people in their 70s. A lot of them have got high blood pressure and diabetes or a bit of respiratory disease. But some of them are coming through who are young and fit.
The patients here have severe pneumonia, inflammation of the lungs. They must be heavily sedated while on a ventilator, a machine which takes over their breathing. Patients can spend 2 weeks like this. Many drugs are being tested, but there is, as yet, no proven treatment for coronavirus.
So it's oxygen and...
And organ support and amazing nursing care, really.
One thing that does help is turning the patients onto their front. It increases the oxygen getting into their lungs. What seems like a simple procedure takes time and lots of pairs of hands.
Okay, everyone all right?
Yep.
Ready, steady, 90.
With ventilated patients, extreme care is needed. All of this while staff wear full personal protective equipment.
Well done, that's great. Okay, can we just check that he's ventilated?
Their only barrier against coronavirus. Every time a doctor or a nurse goes onto the unit, they must don full safety gear.
You can't wear this and work for more than a couple of hours because you've got a crashing headache, you've got a dry mouth, you have to get out.
Staff write their names on their aprons so they can be quickly identified.
So there's an emergency on the ITU. The head of critical care was seeing via walkie-talkie whether he could give a second opinion.
Yeah, do you want to drop and don and come in?
But he needs to be there, so the full kit has to be put on.
They use walkie-talkies because their visors mean they can't communicate on phones. It is draining, physically and mentally.
It's really hard, and some of our staff really can't cope with it. You know, we've got a huge number of nurses, doctors and physios, and not all of them can deal with it, so they can only spend a short time, or not just any time. It's not uncommon for some of our staff to have had panic attacks and just finding this so, so stressful. So we've got to really support people. Some people just can't do it.
Despite the possible risk to themselves, the medical staff carry on. 12-hour shifts, 60 hours a week are the norm. They worry about the patients, about each other, and about those they love.
I think it's very hard on our families. My kids are at home, my wife's homeschooling. It's easy in a way for me. I'm doing my job, I'm busy all day. They don't really know what it's like here, whether we're bringing home the virus. And they've just been amazing. Just let me do what I need to do, and I'm just incredibly grateful to them.
What is striking here is the sense of calm. In the face of adversity, doctors and nurses simply get on with the job.
The staff here are dealing with the biggest challenge ever faced by the NHS. They can save many of the patients, but sadly, not all of them. And still, more patients keep coming every day.
It is harrowing to see the devastation caused by coronavirus, and humbling to witness the resilience of nurses and doctors, the heroes of this crisis. Fergus Walsh, BBC News.